मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, वी आर ऑन चैप्टर 4 कार्बन एंड इट्स कंपाउंड एंड दिस इज मॉड्यूल 1 ऑफ चैप्टर 4. अकरेंस ऑफ कार्बन. कार्बन हुज एटॉमिक नंबर 6 इन द मॉडर्न पीरियोडिक टेबल इज फाउंड इन द एटमॉस्फेयर इनसाइड द अर्थ क्रस्ट एंड इन ऑल लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म. कार्बन इज प्रेजेंट इन फ्यूल्स लाइक वुड, कोल, चारकोल, coke, petroleum, natural gas, biogas that is methane, Mars gas, etc. Carbon is present in compounds like carbonates, hydrogen carbonates that is HNO3, etc. Carbon is found in the free state. Free state here represent elemental form that is C and as diamond, graphite and fullerenes. These all are the allotropic forms of carbon. Or you can say carbon exists in nature in three states mainly: diamond, graphite and fullerenes. You have read in chapter number 3 that diamond is the hardest natural substance. Graphite is a good conductor of electricity as it is non-metal. And fullerenes is a C60 carbon ring, and it has been discovered by Buckminster. So the complete name of this is Buckminster fullerenes. It is a 60 carbon ring. It is shaped like football. So if we talk about bonding in carbon, then it is covalent bonding. Covalent bonding means the bonding that is formed by sharing of electrons. As you know, if the carbon lie at the 6th position in the modern periodic table, then the atomic number of the carbon is 6. Atomic number is represented by the letter Z, and atomic number is equal to number of protons that are positively charged particles present in the nucleus of an atom. So if we talk about electronic configuration, then you all are familiar how to write down electronic configuration. You know about the cells. First cell K, second L, third M and fourth N. While placing electrons into these shells, you should keep this thing in your mind that one cell cannot accommodate more than 8 electrons in its cell. And this scheme is given by Bohr and Bury. That's why we say it is Bohr-Bury scheme. And according to this scheme, you cannot put more than 8 electrons into a cell. So if we write down electronic configuration of carbon, as you know, its atomic number is 6. Then in the first cell, you should put 2 electrons. And then what left behind? 4 electrons are left. These electrons should come in the second shell, that is KL, L shell. So if carbon wants to attain stable configuration or noble gases configuration, then carbon needs 4 more electrons to complete its outermost orbit. So the electrons present in the outermost orbit of an element or of an atom, then these electrons are known as valence electron. So the 4 is the valence electron of carbon. And carbon, the valence electron represent the number of bond that an element can form. So if the valence electrons are 4 in the outermost orbit of the carbon, then carbon can get bonded with 4 other atoms. So 4 is the valency of the carbon, and 4 are the valence electrons of an atom, that is carbon. Valency is the combining capacity of an element. So if carbon wants to attain stable configuration, then carbon needs 4 more electrons. But no other element would ready to give him 4 more electrons. So what carbon will do? Carbon will share the 4 electrons. And the bonding that is formed by sharing of electrons is known as covalent bonding. So there are 3 cases we have. First, elements can form bond either by gaining of electron, losing of electron, or sharing of electrons. So it carbon does not gain 4 electron because it is difficult for the 6 protons to hold 10 electrons, because it does not lose 4 electrons because it needs a large amount of energy to lose 4 electrons. So it shares 4 electrons with other atoms to attain stability, resulting in the formation of covalent bonding. Thank you.